time now for our special Saturday segment, the Corona Dialogue. The Maharashtra government's decision to take over 80% of hospital beds in private hospitals and cap the prices that can be charged for patients in these facilities has sparked off several big questions. Today we look to answer those questions. Should the state use special powers to take over private hospitals? Those are some of the questions. The second question that we want to raise today on the Corona Dialogue is very simply, should the government decide the price structure at such hospitals? The third question that we want to raise, have private hospitals opted out of the COVID fight? Are private hospitals only driven by the profiteering motive? And the fifth big question, is India's healthcare system still dependent on government hospitals in a crisis? Those are the five big questions that we are going to raise on the Corona Dialogue. I'm joined by special guests at the moment. I'm joined by Sujata Rao. She's former health secretary of the government of India. I'm joined by Abhay Soi, chairman Max Healthcare. I will be joined by Dr. Muzaffar Lakdawala. He is a surgeon and the man who is in charge of the Sefi hospital and the efforts being made by the BMC hospital, by the Mumbai Municipal Corporation in working on setting up makeshift COVID hospitals across the city. I also hope to be joined shortly by Naresh Trehan of Medanta. Let's start with all the questions that I want to raise. And the first big question, should the state use special powers to take over private hospitals? Naresh Trehan, what's your view? Do you believe that the state should use special powers to take over private hospitals because they believe private hospitals are not doing enough in this COVID fight, and therefore hospital beds from private hospitals are being taken over by the government? Okay, Dr. Trehan, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Do you believe it's the right step for the state to take over private hospitals because private hospitals, according to the Maharashtra government, for example, are not doing enough to get involved in the COVID fight?
No, private hospitals have to get involved in the fight for sure, and it is in the power of the government today under the Pandemic Act to requisition any hospital which is required. So what have we done from Medanta and Gurugram to supplement the government's efforts? We have adopted a hospital, Medior Hospital, in Manesar, and converted it into a COVID hospital so that we have the capacity to take care of patients which overflow from the government hospitals or otherwise want to get admitted. So this kind of thing is happening around the country, and we private hospitals have volunteered to give beds, and also they
Dr. Trehan, according to the Maharashtra government, 80 to 85% of the burden of the COVID fight in Mumbai, for example, is being done by four government hospitals, and that the private hospitals were overcharging COVID patients, as a result of which the government has been forced to intervene.
So I cannot comment on what's happening in Maharashtra or in Mumbai. I can tell you what's happening in Haryana and Gurugram, because that's the area we are present in. So we the private hospitals have created this facility, a not-for-profit facility in Medior Hospital, which is 150 beds with 20 ICU beds with all the adequate equipment of ventilators and everything that may be required. So this is already happening, that the government has two hospitals and we have created this hospital to augment the facility, and it's open to public. So that was the whole effort. So I don't, I'm sorry I cannot comment about Mumbai because
let
I don't
me,
have the
recommendation. And it's,
let me take that to Dr. Mufassal Lakdawala. You know, Dr. Lakdawala, you are someone who's actually taken the step of working with the government in Mumbai, trying to set up makeshift COVID hospitals, quarantine centers across the city. Do you believe that the private sector at the moment must make that step of working in partnership with the government? Is that the way forward in this COVID fight, a larger public-private partnership?
I think this is a pandemic like none our generation has seen, Ajib, so far. So I believe partnerships are the only model to go. We do know that 80% of the ventilators in the country are controlled by the private sector. We have more than 4/5 of the staff which is stacked up by the private sector. So this is the time to save your city, in my case, Mumbai, and that's why I volunteered to come forward and help with the BMC. We put guidelines in place in the private sector, and all these kind of help improve. It's right. A perfect partnership model.
So you are, what is the challenge? Is it getting the private sector to give more ICU beds, to give more ventilators? Is that why you believe that the private sector therefore needs to work with the government on ensuring that more ICU beds, 80% of ICU beds are being taken over by the government in Mumbai, for example? Do you believe that's the right step?
The problem is that 80% of the patients of corona today are being treated in the public sector. So if you have 80% of ventilators in the private sector and you have 80% of the volume load being handled by the public sector, it's time that we do this partnership, because if we don't do this partnership, we'll probably fail in this war against corona. So I think whilst the government and the BMC in Mumbai's case is building up to get the infrastructure ready, and remember that even European or the American healthcare systems failed in the aftermath of this a massive pandemic. So I think right now is the time to join hands and probably work together and figure out the other things much later. That's what I believe.
Can I therefore come back to you, Dr. Lakdawala, because in Mumbai, for example, in the last 25, 30 years, maybe even stretching more, we haven't had a single major public hospital being added to the city's infrastructure, a city with more than 2 crore people. Some of the hospitals were set up in the British time, which today are serving us today. The King Edward Memorial Hospital is a British legacy. I just want to understand, do you believe that in our focus on private healthcare, we've forgotten to strengthen the public healthcare system, or indeed any kind of public-private partnership?
I think the Seven Hills Hospital in Mumbai is probably one of these examples. That was one of the first hospitals which was a public hospital. Private players came in, like Reliance and various other players came in and then partnered to try and set it up. So I think what Corona has probably done is it has probably served as an awakening call. Today, I am probably running one of the largest facility, and that's a public-private partnership. I do believe, ironically, Rajdeep, it is really funny that we've saved lives of people who could afford the best suite room in a hospital, but unfortunately, there were no beds. And we've put in and saved their lives for 2 days until they got a private hospital room. So I think it's the call of the day is to probably set up these partnerships and going forward, continue with them.
But, you know, I keep getting anecdotal evidence, Dr. Lakdawala, in Mumbai, where people who are non-COVID patients, for example, have said that they've struggled to get a hospital bed at the moment. In Mumbai, they've struggled to get ICU facilities. Is that also a concern that in our focus on COVID, we've lost out on non-COVID patients?
Yes, that has been a concern, and that's something that we've addressed. So what we've done is we've set up holding facilities in almost all DCH or dedicated COVID hospitals. These holding rooms are basically rooms wherein you can either be positive or negative. And we've addressed that concern, because that was a concern until probably a week back, and we've already addressed that, Rajiv.
Dr. Lakdawala, you know, you've become a bit of an iconic figure in Mumbai, because I'm told you've actually not gone home for almost 3 months. Or barely gone home. Setting up this, working with the BMC, how easy or difficult has it been for someone who's used to a private sector system to now work with the government?
It's challenging to say the least, but then these are tough times, and I think we have to live up to our challenges and the things that we are facing. I think one thing I've understood is that the objective is correct. We want to save as many lives as we can. And going forward, the idea of setting up dedicated COVID hospitals has been one, to free up majority of even the public sector hospitals, like you mentioned KEM or NAIR or Sion, to free up to do non-COVID major surgeries. Like you saw Mr. Soy say, and the rest of the speakers, even Mr. Trehan said, we need to free it up. So the idea is to dedicate COVID only to one end and then to do non-COVID so that we can save more lives even for non-COVID, which we are losing right now.
Well, I think all four of you have given us a very interesting perspective. This is what the Corona Dialogues are about, to try and explore new areas and perhaps the public-private healthcare systems post-COVID will undergo some reorientation or a reset. Dr. Trehan, Sujata Rao, Mr. Soy, and Dr. Lakdawala, appreciate your joining us on today's Corona Dialogue.